I'm Dr. David Charles. I'm a neurologist and serve as chairman of the Alliance for Patient Access. It's an organization that ensures patients have access to available therapies. And one of the things we're working on is biologics. Biologics are an incredibly new and innovative class of therapeutics that offer promise to patients with conditions such as breast cancer, rheumatoid arthritis, and multiple sclerosis. And they represent some of the most significant advances in healthcare. When I began my residency, patients diagnosed with multiple sclerosis, often at the prime of their life, were dealing with an illness that was incredibly disabling and relentlessly progressive. Now, today, because of biologics, the diagnosis of MS, again, coming in the prime of life, means that the person, along with their doctor, has a treatment that can really control the illness and can mean that they are productive for years to come. Biologics are a new class of therapeutics that are created from living organisms or cells, and they're often very complex in their manufacturing process and in the final product that's given to patients. They're entirely different than the traditional pharmaceutical, which would be a small molecule that could be easily reproduced as a generic. Biologics, on the other hand, have no generics. They're so complex in their manufacturing process, each step critically important to their safety. Biologics, therefore, are entirely different than a traditional pharmaceutical that can be made as a generic. They're often tailored for the individual patient, sometimes after the patient's been tested, just to know that the patient is going to respond to this therapy. One of the things we're working on in the Alliance for Patient Access is the issue of therapeutic substitution. Now, this is different than generics. Therapeutic substitution is when your doctor writes a prescription, you go to the pharmacy, and it's actually switched to a different drug. Not a generic, but actually a different drug. In the case of biologics, this is unacceptable because biologics are so precise to the particular condition that you're treating. It could be multiple sclerosis or breast cancer or a particular type of arthritis. The particular biologic that your doctor prescribes has to be filled just the way you and your physician have decided. Decisions like this that you make with your physician are not decisions that can be left to an insurance company. As chairman of the Alliance for Patient Access, I understand the importance of how policy affects the development of new therapeutics, such as biologics. In the case of biologics, simply stated, there's no shortcut. One of the important things to consider concerning biologics is cost, and everyone's concerned about cost. However, in this particular class of therapeutics, the incredible promise that they hold for the future, the promise that they're paying off right now for patients with cancer, with multiple sclerosis, and other conditions is incredible. There is significant cost, but that cost is worth it. The federal government purchases well over half of all healthcare in the United States. When you combine the Centers for Medicare and Medicaid Services, Medicare, Medicaid, the Veterans Administration, Department of Defense, and federal workers, it's an incredible investment that our government is making in healthcare. So it's critically important that as a nation, we get these policies right, that physicians, that patients, that regulatory agencies, and manufacturers all come together to find policies that ensure an environment where these new biologics that hold so much promise can come to market and help our patients, and at the same time, as a nation, that we can afford these therapies and that they're available to all that need them. It is so important that our policymakers take up the issue of biologics with seriousness and understand the importance of this class of therapeutics.